Hi, magandang araw sa inyo lahat. Good day to all of you again. This is Francisco J. Colaico, FJC for short, bidding you a good welcome again in our weekly vlog. This week, we're going to talk about mutual funds. Why? Because again, we've received a lot of comments and questions on what would be a most recommended venue or tool for regular savings and where to place them. Mutual funds is another term for what I call collective investing. Ito yung bakasan tayo. Individuals co-own an investment company by investing yung kanyang savings, and each peso saved is a share in that collective fund, which is called a mutual fund. Essentially, this is a private company licensed by the BSP and SEC, authorized to sell their ownership shares to the public. And what do they do with the money? Well, put it simply, the money is managed by an investment management firm, separate from the company itself. The company itself is owned by the investors like me and you who put money, savings, in buying their shares. The money collected is managed by a third company called the fund management company that is the expert in deploying where to invest the money. There are many kinds of mutual funds. Ito yung tinatawag na equity fund, naka-invest sa stock market. A little high risk, no guarantee in return yan, but sa galing ng fund manager, they allot investments in different sectors of the stock market. And depending on the objective of the fund, each fund has a basic objective. Iba ang performance nila. Then you have a fixed income fund na invested naman sa tinatawag na fixed income instruments like bonds. Then there is another mutual fund called the balance fund, a mix of the two. But this vlog is not about talking on the technique of or lecturing about mutual fund. The question I want to address is, who is the best investor for mutual funds? What are mutual funds good for? I am an investor of the mutual fund. My grandchildren are investors in mutual funds for the simple reason that mutual funds allow you to invest regularly. So it is a good way, magandang paraan yan, para mag-save tayo ng konti-konti pera. Buwan-buwan, or linggo-linggo, or every other month, or every quarter, naglalagak tayo ng salapi, bumibili tayo ng shares ng mutual fund, na hoping na yung value ng shares na yan lumalago. Okay? Now, may guarantee ba yan? Wala. May taon na bumababa ang value, may taon na tumataas. Volatile yung market na yan. But for the last 20, 30 years, nag-average yan na pataas. So what is the best answer, but the best feature of mutual fund is the simple possibility na yung kung may maliit kang pera, dahil 1,000 pesos lang pwede ka na mag-invest dyan. Hindi ka kailangan bilyonaryo. Yung maliit na savings yung buwan-buwan, pwede mo isatabi at ilagak sa mutual fund by 1,000 pesos worth every 15th or every 30th of the month and let it grow. So if the fund averages 10% per year in 30 years, mga 2 million na yan. Ang nalaga, in 30 years, mga 2 million plus na yan. Ang nailagak mo lang yan, 360,000 na. If it averages 10%, and that average has been achieved by the fund, by mutual funds in general. The last 5 years has not been good, okay? But that's another story, I'll discuss that later. For now, I just want to know, who is the best investor for mutual funds? The answer is you and I, especially if you are young, because mutual funds is good for those who have time. Mutual funds is the best investment na dahan-dahan mo to put small amounts, so that it will grow over time. Remember, compounding is your best ally in investing, growing your asset. Time and regular savings, say 1,000 pesos a month, 500 pesos a month, this is the best investment. Huwag natin kakalimutan doon that when you invest, may target tayo. Once you hit the target, halimbawa naglalagay ka ng 1,000 a month and your target is to save 200,000. Once the value of your investment is already 200,000, withdraw mo na, gamitin mo for whatever purpose you want. Remember, when you invest, you have to think of exit. You have to have a target and a timeline and a purpose. Yan ba yung pang down payment for a house? O yan ba for the education of my child? O yan ba is for something else? Once you hit that target, liquidate, sell it. Before you know it, yung akala mo you will need to save 10 years, 7 years, nakuha mo na yung target mo, or 4 years, nakuha mo na. Posible yan. Posible rin hindi. But to lose your money, impossible. Remember, mutual funds is a long-term investment. It is not for putting money this month and withdrawing next month, or putting money this week and withdrawing next week, or putting money this year and withdrawing next year. Put your money there and leave it for at least 5, hopefully more than 5 years. Mararamdaman nyo ang galaw ng pera at paglago ng pera. Yung RSIP, Regular Savings Investment Program namin sa KSK, very simple ang rule namin doon. You cannot withdraw unless you have made 10%. You've grown your money 10%. You're not allowed to withdraw. Some have grown 10% less than a year, a few months. Some inabot ng 2 years. Why? Depende kung anong kailan ka nag-umpisa. Now, the next question. Is this the time to invest in mutual funds? My answer is simple. Now is always the best time. But now is even more logically the best time. Why? The peak value of mutual funds and the index of the stock market was about 2 years ago. The peak. Stock market index was about 9,000 plus. Ngayon it's 7,000. The peak of one of the leading mutual funds was a value, net asset value, 46 pesos. Ngayon nasa 38, 39 lang siya. So, ibig sabihin, bumaba in the last 2 years ang value ng funds. Therefore, in my view, this is the best time to come in. Buy low. Remember, bibili ka, papasok ka, pag mababa. At habang bumababa, dapat pumapasok ka rin. So, that answers the question. How long will you stay? Again, I say, please keep your money more than 5 years. But unless you've already achieved your target, let's say bumulusok after 1 year, like times 3 na ka na, withdraw. Fine, it's okay. You're allowed to do that. Remember, purpose, timeline, and target. PTT. When you invest, you have to know why you're investing, how much you want to invest, and how much you want to your money to grow to, so that you know when you can, you know also when you want to withdraw. That is purpose, time, and timeline. Remember, this is collective investing. This is not the only tool for investing, but this is the best and initial tool, especially if you're just coming into the employment market. Put aside a small amount. The younger you are, the less amount of money you need. Why? Because you have more time. The younger you are, the less amount of money you need to save to invest in mutual funds. For the simple reason I emphasize this is because you're young and you have more time. This is very important. And if you have only a small amount to invest, there's really any hardly any other opportunity for regular investment except other than mutual funds or what I call collective investing. Call us at KSK at CFE. We'll advise you on what funds would be appropriate for your purpose and for the timing that you may want to consider. This is very important. So before I go, next week we'll tackle other issues. Please do not forget, press that button and subscribe. Send us your questions, more questions. And if you want to come here and join me for a discussion, I'll welcome it more than more than you think I would. Because I think this is something I want to promote. I learned from you. Hopefully you learn from me. See you again next week.